Good morning students. So in this video we will see what is adjoint of a matrix. In the chapter determinant, what is called adjoint of a matrix and some other properties of this adjoint of a matrix, and what is singular matrix, and then we will go for inverse of a matrix. Okay, so what is adjoint of a matrix? Adjoint means the adjoint of a square matrix. It must be a square matrix because this matrix is related with the chapter determinant, so it must be a square matrix. So adjoint of a square matrix is the transpose of the cofactors of the elements of the matrix. If A is a matrix, then we will find the first cofactors of the elements of the matrix, and then we will do the transpose of the cofactors. Then what matrix will come? That is called adjoint of the matrix A. And adjoint of A can be denoted by A, B, J of A means adjoint of A. Okay? So if a matrix is any matrix is there, if we take any matrix A is equal to 1, 5, 2, 3. Okay? So what is the how to find the adjoint of A? Adjoint of A will be first the element's cofactors you will find. So since it is 2 by 2, so its cofactor will be 3, 1's cofactor will be 3, 5's cofactor will be 2, 2's cofactor will be 5, and 3's cofactor will be 1. Now one more thing is there. Cofactor, when I have told, first one is positive, second one is negative. So what will happen? The sign of this one will become negative cofactor, and cofactor of this one is again positive negative, so this is also it is minus. Alright? So it is plus minus minus, this is plus. So this one main diagonal will be, what will happen? When you change, it will remain only sign, it is sign will remain same, but here after changing, sign also will be changed. Now this is, we have done only cofactor. Now transpose of this one, we have to find adjoint. Adjoint means cofactor and its transpose. So transpose we have to do. So when we do the transpose, what will happen? Transpose, row will change into columns, then it is called transpose. So it is 3, minus 2, minus 5, 1. So this is the adjoint of A. Alright? This is called adjoint of A. So what is happening? Look at that. If length is 2 by 2, adjoint is main diagonal position change. Main diagonal element's position is changed, and off diagonal sign change. Then this is called adjoint. Okay? Got the point? If it is 3 by 3 matrix, then each element's first cofactor will find, and then we will do the transpose. Then we will get the adjoint of it. Alright? Okay? So, one 3 by 3 also will see. So, if A is a 3 by 3 matrix, how to find the adjoint of this matrix? So, it is 3 by 3. So, elements are A11, A12, A13, A21, like that. So, what will be the first? You can do each element, we have to do each element's cofactor. So, cofactor of A11, say A11. Okay? So, what is A11's cofactor? It is this. What will be that? 3, 5. 0, 1. Alright? And since it is first one is positive, so it is positive only. Alright? So what is that? 3 minus 0, it is 3. So cofactor of 1 is 3. Alright? A12. Since second place is negative, so what will happen? Minus of which one? By leaving this column and this row, what are the elements? It is 2, 5, minus 2, 1.
Alright? Here, whatever sign is there, we will not see. Okay? That we will not see, only except that what elements are remaining. Leaving these rows and columns, what elements are remaining? It's determinant. And this sign is the position sign 1, 2. So it is 1, 2 means 1 plus 2 is 3. So it will be what number of places it will be negative. Okay? So what will be that? 2 ones are 2 and plus 10. So minus of 2 plus 10. So it is how much? Minus 12. Minus 12 is the cofactor of minus 1. Alright? A13. This position is plus, minus, plus. So we are taking plus sign. So leaving this column and this row, what elements are there? 2, 3, minus 2, 0. Alright? So what will be that? 0 minus of minus 6 means plus 6. So 6 is the cofactor of this element. So like that, each element's cofactor we have to do. Instead of doing all this separately, first for practice purpose you can do separately, but after learning of this one, you can do directly also this one. Each element's cofactor directly you can write, and then we will do the transpose, then we can get the adjoint of A. Alright? So, like that, we have to find other 6 elements. 3 elements only I have found out, other 6 elements has to be found out. Okay? So, what will be the cofactors of other elements? Okay, first one I am showing A21, what will be that? A21 cofactors are A21 is this one, this element. So, leaving this row and this column, these 4 elements. So, what will happen? It is 2-1, 2 plus 1 is 3, so it is negative. So, what are the 4 elements? Minus 1, 2, 0, and 1. So, what is that? Minus 1. So, minus of minus 1 is 1. A22. So, 2 plus 2 is 4. It is even. So, it is positive only. So, these elements we are going to find. A22. So, which elements? 1, 2 and minus 2, 0. Minus 2, 1. So, what will be the cofactor? 1 plus 4. Means it is 5. A23. 2 plus 3 is 5. What number? So it is negative. Okay? So 2, 3 is this one. So its cofactor will be taking these 4 elements. So it is 1 minus 1 minus 2, 0. So what will be that? 0. Minus 2. 0 minus 2 is minus 2 and minus of minus 2 is 2. Okay? So A23 like that. A31. 3 plus 1 is 4, so it is again positive. So A31 which element? This element, its cofactor will be taking this 4, leaving this row, this column and this row. So it is minus 1, 2 and 3, 5. So what will be that? Minus 5, minus 6, minus 11. Minus 11 is the cofactor. A32. 3 plus 2 is 5. So again here it is, it will be negative of that. A32 is this one, 0. So its cofactor is leaving this row and this column. So what are that? 1, 2, 2, 5. 1, 2, 2, 5. So 5 minus 4 is 1, so it is minus 1. Minus 1 is A33. A33, this element. 3 plus 3 is 6, this is even, so it is positive only. What will be that? What will be that? 1 minus 1. And only this 4, 1 minus 1, 2, 3. So what will be that? 3 plus 2, is 5. So these are the cofactors of every element. Alright. So now we'll write, we have to find the adjoint of this. So adjoint of A. First we will write the cofactors. Alright. So first one was 3. A12 it was minus 12. A13 it was 6. A21 it was 1. Next A22 it is 5. A23 it is 2. A31 it is minus 11. A32 it is minus 1. And it is 5. Now this matrix, it is, we have done only cofactor, so its transpose. Transpose of this cofactor will be the adjoint of it. So what will be the transpose of this one? It is, this row will become in column. So it is 3, minus 12, 6. Then second row will become second column, 1, 5, 2. And third row will become the third column, minus 11, minus 1, and 5. So this is the adjoint of the matrix A, 3 by 3. Got it clear? Alright? Okay? Now, we will see two properties of this adjoint. So, two properties I told. So, properties, first one is A into adjoint of A will be equal to adjoint of A into A matrix A will be equal to determinant of A into identity matrix. So, this is the first property. Okay? Second one is determinant of adjoint of A. If A is of order n, then determinant of adjoint of A will be equal to determinant of A to the power n minus 1. If it is order 3, this is a square matrix. If order 3, this will be 3 minus 1, 2, means determinant of A square. If it is 2, if it is order 2, then determinant of adjoint of A will be equal to determinant of A to the power 2 minus 1 means 1, only determinant of A. Okay, so for 2 by 2 matrix, determinant of adjoint of A is determinant of A. Okay, now here one thing we have to take care, this about this A, this determinant of A should not be equal to 0. That means determinant of A should not be equal to 0. Okay, so what is that? What is the meaning of this? This matrix, if determinant of a matrix is not equal to 0, then it is called non-singular. When a matrix is called singular matrix, in that one point is there, singular matrix. What is singular matrix? A matrix is said to be singular if determinant of A equal to 0. Then the matrix is said to be singular. So if the determinant of A is equal to 0, then A is singular. So for these cases, the A must be a non-singular matrix. If it is a non-singular matrix, then only this property is applicable. Okay? And while going to the inverse of a matrix also, that determinant of A must be not equal to 0. Because the matrix must be a non-singular, then only we can, inverse can exist. Okay? So next we will see what is inverse of a matrix. Alright? So for an inverse, when a matrix can be invertible, I have told just now, a square matrix A is invertible if, means if and only if A is non-singular, means determinant of A should not be equal to 0. So how to find the inverse? Previously also we have seen, previous videos, if two matrices are said to be invertible, if AB is equal to BA is equal to I, means identity matrix, then B, A is called the inverse of B or B is called the inverse of A,
Alright. Now, just now we have seen a property. What is that? A into adjoint of A is equal to adjoint of A into A. This is equal to determinant of A into I. Alright. So, now how to find the inverse of a matrix? Look at that. What we know, if AB is equal to BA is equal to I, then it is called invertible. Now what happens, if we take from here, A into adjoint of A, and this determinant of A, if we divide by determinant of A, then what we are getting, it is as, we are getting as identity matrix. Now, we are look at that, this portion, A into this portion is equal to I, means these portions can become B, or otherwise this is, reversely also we have written, no, that this is equal to adjoint of A into A, this is also there, okay. So what happens, if we do this one, then this can be equal to, if we divide that one, means adjoint of A by determinant of A into the matrix A. So what we are getting, this portion, look at that, it is A into B and this is B into A. So this result is I only, means identity matrix. So what is inverse from the previous concept? If AB is equal to BA is equal to I, then A is the inverse of B or B is the inverse of A. Alright? So here what we are getting? Inverse of A is what? Which one? Adjoint of A by determinant of A. Now this determinant of A, if it is 0, then it is undefined. So determinant of A must not be 0. Means A must be a non-singular. Okay? A must be a non-singular matrix, then only the inverse can exist. So what is the inverse of A? Then inverse of A, you can write A inverse is equal to adjoint of A by determinant of A. Okay? So this is the inverse of the matrix. Inverse of a matrix is adjoint of A by determinant of A. For that reason, we are learning now here adjoint, how adjoint can be used to find the inverse of a matrix, and this using the determinant. Alright? So now we will see how we can find the one or two examples. So how to find the inverse of this matrix 2 by 2? Okay? By using determinant. So for that, what first we have to see? You can take the matrix A is, matrix A is equal to 2 minus 2, 4, 3. So first what we have to check, whether the matrix is non-singular or not. If it is non-singular, then only inverse can exist. If it is singular, inverse cannot exist. So first you have to see the determinant of A. So determinant of A, how to find? It is this diagonal multiplication minus of diagonal multiplication. So 2, 3 are 6 and plus it is minus of minus, it is 8. So it is 14. So it is not equal to 0. So inverse exists. Therefore, A inverse exists. First, we have to check that one. So, how to find the inverse? For that, we have to find the adjoint of A by determinant of A. So, what is adjoint of A? So, first, we'll find what is adjoint of A. Adjoint of A. Adjoint of A is nothing but the transpose of the cofactors. So, how to find adjoint? For 2 by 2, it is very simple to find. Main diagonal, you exchange, and off diagonal, change the sign. So, main diagonal exchange, it is 3, this is 2, and this only sign change, minus 4 and 2. Okay? Then it will become the adjoint of A. Alright? For this 3 by 3, you have to do first cofactor and then you have to do the transpose. And here, if this adjoint directly you can find for 2 by 2 matrix. Main diagonal exchange, main diagonal elements should be exchanged, and off diagonal sign change, then adjoint of A1. So what will be A inverse? A inverse will be equal to adjoint of A by determinant of A. So what will be that? Adjoint of A is what? This matrix by determinant of A is 14. So 1 by 14 into adjoint of A is B2 minus 4, 2. Okay? So this is the inverse of this matrix A. Inverse of A is 1 by 14 of this matrix. Alright? So next we will see 1 3 by 3. So how to find the inverse of this 3 by 3 matrix? So first we will take that A is equal to, this matrix we will take, this is 1, 3, 5, 0, 3, 2, 0, 0, minus 1. So first what we have to find, we have to check whether it is non-singular or not. So determinant of A we have to find. So by here 2 elements are 0, so by this row if you do it, you can get it. Or here with this column also you can do, here 2 elements are 0, easily you can find. So by expanding if you do along R1, so it is 1 into what will be there into its covector. So it is minus 3 minus 0. So it is what is that? Minus 3 is the determinant of A. So this is not equal to 0. So inverse exists. Therefore, A inverse exists. Now, for finding the inverse, what we have to do is adjoint of this A we have to find. So how to find adjoint of A? Adjoint of A. Adjoint of A is transpose of the cofactors. Transpose of the cofactors. So here directly I am finding out. Just we observe cofactors of 1. So it is first is positive, it is positive 1. So this 4. So it is minus 3. Minus 3 into minus 3 minus 0 is means minus 3. So cofactor of 1 is minus 3. What is cofactor of 0? Leaving this column and this row, these 4 elements are there. So it is minus 3 minus 0. So it is minus 3. And position sign is negative, so it is plus 3. Okay? Next, this 0 is what is the cofactor? This 4. So 6 minus 15. 6 minus 15 is minus 9. Minus 9 is the cofactor. Next cofactor of this 3, leaving this row and this column, this 4, so it is 0 only. 0 minus 0 is 0. So 0 cannot be positive or negative, so it is 0 only. Next, this 3 is leaving this row, this column and this row, these 4 elements, so it is minus 1. Okay? Minus 0 means minus 1. Position sign is positive only, so it is minus 1 only. Now this element, it is position sign is negative. So by leaving this row and this column, this 4 element, 2 minus 0 is 2. So position sign is minus, so it is minus 2. Directly you can find cofactors. Next, these elements. So this 4 element, by leaving this column and this row, so it is 0 minus 0, so it is 0 only. Next, this one, it is again position sign is positive, negative, positive, it is again negative. So what will be that? This 4, it is also again 1 into 0 minus 3 into 0 is 0. Okay? Now these elements, these 4 elements, so it is 3 minus 0, so it is 3. Now transpose of that will be the adjoint. So transpose will do it, changing, it is minus 3, 3, minus 9. Then 0, minus 1,
-2, -2, -0, -0, 3. So this is the adjoint of the matrix A. Now what will be A inverse? A inverse will be equal to adjoint of A by determinant of A. So determinant of A is how much? -3. So -1/3 into adjoint of A is -3, -0, -3, -1, -9, -2, 3. Okay. Now what will happen? Most of the places it is multiple of 3, so we can divide by 3, and minus sign is there. So what will be that? This is A inverse will be equal to -3. Okay, so 3 gets cancelled, so it is 1. This is 0 by everything is 0. 0. Next is 3, so it is -1. -9, it is 3. Next it is minus means 1/3. This is 2/3. And this one is -1. This is 0. So this is the inverse of the matrix A. That way you can find the inverse of the matrix. Okay? Got it? Clear? Alright. Thank you.